Greetings and welcome to episode 36 of my Empire Total War Darth Mod Russia campaign. And this, my friends, I left it last time, where we had a tumultuous episode, my friends, last time around. We had a brief skirmish, shall we say, my friends, with the Prussians. They declared war on us, and we took some territory off them, but it was only, I would sort of class that as a minor skirmish, because we didn't really go into that full-scale brutal war where we're both absolutely trying to throw armies, and you're sort of trying to sort of grind your way through layers and layers of defences, that elaborate defensive network that either side has set up. No, this was more a sort of a skirmish, more of a test of strength. We were both probing and prodding our defences to see where the weak spot was, but fortunately sense has prevailed, sanity has prevailed, and we offered Prussia a peace treaty and they accepted it, but they accepted it with an added bonus, especially for us, of a military alliance. Now this secures our western sort of frontier, our western flank, our northern flank should I say, where the whole length pretty much from Vienna all the way, my friend, to St. Petersburg here is pretty much now secure, as we are allied with Prussia, which I did not see coming at all. We just couldn't possibly have seen this happening at all. Prussia is in an absolutely a brutal, brutal war with France. They really are absolutely battering each other to pieces here. And for us, that is absolutely fine. It gives us a chance to replenish, recruit, take some deep breaths, but also vitally to really, really build up our economy, to really give our economy a massive boost. And to that end, my friends, we have invested exceptionally heavily here in Hungary and in Serbia. We've absolutely thrown almost 30,000 gold into these two regions in a single year. Now that pretty much constitutes our profit for an entire year in one go. That is how much we have sunk into the economy here, because it is an ever, it's an increasing circle. The more you pump into your economy, the more you're going to get out of it. And remember, we're trying to find that balance, that equilibrium between military and economy. Without economy, you don't have a military, and without the military, you can't keep economy safe. So again, we've got to find that delicate balance between the two. We can't be absolutely spending huge amounts of money on our army, and then when the trade is hit, not because of us, but because of wars from other nations being blockaded, then we see our economy absolutely shrinking quite quickly, which means that we have to, the internal economy, the Russian economy itself, has to absorb the costs of military and naval forces. Now, last time that happened, where most of the other nations were at war with each other and they were blockading each other, we saw the trade shrink massively, but we still had 15,000 to 20,000 gold coming in per turn from our internal economy, what Russia was producing itself. Now that kept us afloat during that quite lean time, but what we really want to do now is get to a position where our economy is so far ahead that we can spend massively on our armies, because although the western flank is secured here, we do have Venice looking a little bit decidedly dicey in our favour, in their favour, my friends. We've only got this small garrison here in Zagreb in Croatia. We do have a huge influx of troops here. Look at this. We've absolutely rammed in, well, an army group and another army as well in here to defend, especially Hungary, since we've invested so much, and also Vienna. We can also divert troops from these regions here to sort of aid in Zagreb, but realistically, we need to try and put another army into here, a full stack army into Zagreb, just to cover this border here. We've got two armies here in Galicia and Podolia, which we took from the Prussians, and they seem to have backed off quite severely. They've got a university, a sort of small sort of scouting force here in Krakow. They have pretty much left Minsk and Vilnius alone here. We do have this pretty stern army here, an excellent army here that obviously can fight with panache and Alain if need be. We're also starting to put together here a secondary army here in St. Petersburg. St. Petersburg is an absolute critical economic hub for us. As you can see, 14,000 of our income here comes from or flows through St. Petersburg, so it's vital we hold this economic link open. It is also a crucial border between us and Sweden. As you can see, a huge amount of trade comes in and flows out from Sweden across the straits here in the Baltic Sea. We also have this army here, which is sort of guarding the Moscow frontier. Now Moscow is only a small sort of jaunt away here if the Prussians were ever to attack us through this sort of corridor. As we don't really have this corridor well protected, we've got one army wishing to do so, that's not really enough. Our aim is to have Kiev as with a full stack garrison and also a second force here, maybe within the wooded area here along this sort of border here with Belarus. And I think the most immediate threat to us is going to be here from the Persians. The Persians have taken Venice out here, which you can see Venice did have an army here, but that was expelled here from the Don. And what we really need to do is keep an eye on here. This Don crossing cannot be breached here at all by the Persians. The Persians have expanded their empire. Huge, look at this. All of this is Persian. All of it. All the way up. Initially, Chechnya was ours, and also the Don was ours. We had to give the Don to the Venetians as a peace treaty to unblockade St. Petersburg. But now, as you can see, Persia has it. And I'm not too happy with that at all. I want additional forces here. I'm going to put at least another full-stack army here, possibly even two. So Moscow is going to be producing these units, as you can see. Because we've invested in the infrastructure, because we have the best roads in this region, we can now send forces all the way down here pretty much in one go. If we didn't have the infrastructure, we hadn't invested, we wouldn't be able to do that. And as you can see, trade is flowing nicely through here. Savoy has been cut off, unfortunately, from us. But that is just one of those things. We also have this fleet here guarding the entrance here, because these are vital ports, particularly the Crimean port. That really is a vital thing here. But as you can see, Savoy has been cut off, so we are looking at sort of opening up that trade route if possible. And also we have pretty much crushed all of the sort of resistance here in the Middle East. The Middle East is going to be our priority now. We want to crush the last resistance of the Ottomans in Cairo and in Baghdad. If we can take those two, then all of the Middle East here is ours. And then we can really start to push on here. We will then be bumping into Spain here in Tripolitania, which is pretty much North Africa, and that's fine, that's what we want here. But let's have a quick look while we're at it at how the Ottomans hostile towards us. They really don't like us. -50, -155, so the chances are the war will break out with us. Well, they got Persia on their side, we can't take the chance. They got Great Britain, Prussia and the Mughal, so we're going to have to wait for them to declare war upon us. We will not be taking the war to the Ottomans unless they come for us. Let's see if we can get a trade agreement. Maybe just, nope, they really don't like us at all, so that's not going to happen. So we're going to continue to build up our forces here. We do have this army here, which can sort of patrol and, you know, garrison between these two, Damascus and also Palestine. We've started trying to put another force here together to try and, you know, strike at the Ottomans at the opportune time. And we are investing pretty heavily here in Ankara here. I think Ankara is going to be pretty safe. I really would like to get this a fortified city. That's a big investment though, 12,000, but it might be worth it. It might be worth it in the long run to have this as a walled settlement, because you just never know here. And also we've pretty much exhausted all possibilities of our research and development until we get some additional research that can open up these. We've got Wealth of Nations. Let's get Wealth of Nations. Why that has stopped, I don't know, but that's a huge boost to our income here if we get that three turns. Okay, let's have a quick look and make sure that we've got coming in. We've got 36,520. So you can see we have our tax from our internal economy, keeping the army, and also we get an additional 5,000 left over from that. So as you can see, we are balancing out our economy and our armies pretty well here. And actually we could probably get additional two units in here when we get a chance. I want this a full stack army. I want everything to be absolutely firing on all cylinders here. We cannot allow anything here to jeopardize that. And in fact, I'll put this army within striking distance of Warsaw. Thus, we are actually, no, wait a minute. We'll straddle the road. We'll cut the road here. The road will be used, then we'll hit Lublin and then strike from Lublin all of the Warsaw. If Prussia ever crosses us again, we get allied with them. So quick look how they view us at the moment. +167. So because we've got the military alliance with them, things are looking okay. So we can invest elsewhere. We can look at other targets now, because that flank, we've also moved this force here from Patras to Athens, because Athens really is an absolute crucial hub here for us. We are, I believe, Yes, we got two additional ships being built here. And yeah, two more here. So these are going to produce the navy that's going to be sent to other, to attack other nations to keep and defend Russia further afield. But my friends, without further ado, let's end this turn. We're going to keep a close eye on what happens here. This really does affect us in a big way, what happens between Prussia and France. It is a vital conflict, indirectly to us, because what happens here, if Prussia overwhelms France, we are looking at an absolute gigantic, gigantic ally, but also a potential possible future foe, and that's something we have to keep our eye on here. It really is. Let's end the turn, my friends. Let's see what comes our way. I'm not sure if many of you have seen the brand new Warhammer, demo that came out today on the 29th. I've got to say I'm pretty excited for it. I am a big Warhammer buff. It played a huge part in my sort of early years, shall we say, and I am a really I've got good hopes for it. And I really am looking forward to it. I really, really hope they just really absolutely get that really spot on. It looks really, really good. Let me know what you think about it, my friends, and see whether you're looking forward to it, what happens. But I am looking forward to it. If it goes as well as it looks, then oh, fingers crossed, everything should be okay. But we've got Prussia. Let's have a look what they're going to do. Berlin seems to be... Oh, that's right on the border there, to Brussels, right on the border. Whoa, 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 looks like they got... Wait a minute, is that a rebellion there? Are they facing an internal rebellion? Now that would be a huge... Ah... Now they want Comey. Not a chance, not a chance. No, we'll do that. But you're not getting any territory from me whatsoever. Not a chance. Ooh, Sweden. Will Sweden hit back against Prussia? Because they are coming under a huge amount of threat here from Prussia. Persia gathering its strength. Will it? Whoa, 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 I don't like the look of that at all. Why? Denmark, Pueblo Nations, Venice, they've got some forces there. I've got to keep an eye on what's happening there. The more desperate they come, you tend to see them striking out pretty hard against those they want to try and gather as many resources as they can before they sort of almost see themselves collapsing into nothingness. They're not going to be coming for us. Pirates. Let's have a look here. Oh, excellent. Plus one to morale. Fantastic. We've got... Oh my word, this is more like it. Beautiful, look at that. And we've got these here. So what we are going to do is going to combine these ships together to bring ourselves our first fleet, our second fleet here. Eventually get this up to full. We are going to combine this, though, with some smaller, more agile ships to give us that little bit of oomph. Moscow, look at that. So we've got some, we have now got some other armies. Now we've got the production here, another army. But as many of you have said here, Mala, you need to get your infrastructure up running in terms of your navy, your guns. You know, really throw some things, some money at bringing these infrastructures up here, some army staff colleges. So I'm going to do that for Dan. I'll take your advice as always, my friends, and do that. So what have we got here? Commercial port. Ah, look at that. That is just right. We are going to invest 2,000 in here because that's again going to improve our economy excellently here. But what we will do, I think, is we'll put these gentlemen immediately into the Don army here. Look at that, because we've got those roads. Look how far they can travel. They've almost reached the Don here in one go, which is fantastic. It means quick reinforcement for us. What about this here? 4,000. Ooh, that might be a worth. I think we're going to invest in this here. Water power cloth mill here. So we have to keep Tartaria. We have to keep Tartaria here under our control, because we're investing in here. We can't afford to lose any of these. What about here? Water powered mill. Oh, 1,200 here. I think we're going to start investing again in our economy, keeping this as high as possible. But the infrastructure here, are they doing here? Ooh. Oh, look at that. 1,000. Again, we're going to invest in there as well. We're not going to leave any of these sort of outer regions here to just sort of wither and die. We're going to invest in them, every single one of them. How are we doing here with infrastructure? That's fine. Got 22,000 left. What have we got coming in? 40,000, because we're doing that, my friends. That's the reason why. 4,500 here for that. Not yet. Infrastructure is good there. Ooh. 5,000 of commercial. That's pretty remote, but look at those Danish forces here. If they come for us, we would be pushed, but we're not going to. Army Staff College, I think we are going to do is invest in Army Staff College here in Moscow. And we do need to get some additional forces being... Actually, we'll invest in the Army Staff College here as well. Let's get our infantry up to spec here. We've got 10,000 left. What can we invest in here on the border? And we're going to invest in Army Staff College here as well. We do have 4,000 left. Can we invest anything here? Because it's going to be a real pivotal point here. Vienna. Wait a minute. 375. Now what we are going to do is invest here in Gunnery School. I think what we will do is can we get any more troops recruited here? We can. Oh, look at the Streltsy here, but not as good as the Hussars or the Heavy Cav. Look at the Heavy Cav. But I really, we need to focus pretty much on here, so we are going to invest here in some more infantry. Like I promised, my friends, we are going to keep this frontier as strong as possible. We don't want the Persians breaking into this region at all. What's the cannon like here? I think we got 3 cannon. That's, ooh, look at that. They're right on the border with the Crimea. I don't like the look of that there, because the Crimea is unprotected. They do have some pretty mobile units here. So we are going to have to watch out for that. Crimea is pretty important to us. We don't have any armies in the region here at all. What about the... why aren't these repaired? Oh, of course, we've got these to need... we're recruiting one more gun here. We're going to replenish these guns here. Put 2 24-pounders in here. We're a bit bare here of armies here. So Kiev is going to be used as a staging point. We're going to put another army around into Crimea, ready to strike. This army would be hard-pressed if we were pushed, but they'd have to jump across here, because they can't do... which means they'd have to go around this way, or then their naval forces would have to come out. And there's their navy there. So this navy here would probably be able to crush them pretty quickly, but would it get there before anything else? Difficult to say. 2 more turns for that. Let's end the turn, my friends. Let's see what happens. Great Britain. Looks like they're hitting Spain. France reinforcing the Western Front. Ooh, that's a lot of troops there. Looks like they're reinforcing Munich. Ooh, they're striking across the border. Madrid, Spain. I'm surprised Spain hasn't struck out against somebody just yet. Oh, the Dutch have risen again. The rebels, they must really be absolutely under a lot of pressure there, the Prussians. As you can see, they can field so many forces. Well, that was over quickly, that rebellion, but that doesn't mean they've got a lot of problems there in Amsterdam. Because the Dutch are really throwing everything they can at there, that, especially the rebels. Surprises Sweden hasn't responded against the Prussians in Copenhagen. Sweden still just about there. They are good allies with us. Is Persia, but by damn, they got some. Ooh. Looks like they're fighting the jeepers creepers. What exactly are they doing there? I think they might be bankrupt. I think Venice might be bankrupt. Because look, they're starting to lose troops here. That means they might strike out against us in desperation. We're gonna have to be Syria. That's good. That means we can move an agent down here and see what's going on in Baghdad. Actually, we got that already. We should have moved him back here. It's too late. But let's have a look what's going on down here properly. We should move the gentleman back to find out what's going on in Cairo. It's my mistake, but got 40,000 there. Great arsenal. Almost ready there. We get a great arsenal up and running as well. Just in case, because remember, we still got excuse me, we still got the Spanish to deal with as well. Pottery, let's get that up and running as well. Romalia, so we're going to replace one of these here. We're going to disband this, and in its place we're going to put the 24 pounder, and we're going to disband that one. Then eventually, let's get another 24 pounder into here. We're coming in 40,841. As soon as these start to kick in, we're going to invest in the internal economy before we go for the trade. Excuse any noise in the background, my friends. The trade can wait. Governor's Palace, let's make a statement that we're actually going to be staying here. And we'll make this here a bawdy house for the happiness, which thankfully, thanks to your advice, my friends, you told me to break this down from a university and make it into sort of one of the happier buildings, the building that gives happiness, and it's worked an absolute treat. As you can see here, Munich is, my word, that's a lot of fire coming in here. Look at the raiding going on here. It's mind-boggling. Ooh. Okay, great estates. Let's cross the border. Now, what else can we invest in here? Naval board. Do we need a naval board? We don't really. That would be a waste of money there. What's the infrastructure like? Good. The economy here is thriving pretty well here. Make sure the infrastructure and everywhere is just going along nicely. Trying to invest everywhere we can here. Do we need this? No, we don't. We can make it into something else that's going to give us a better profit. They've moved away from there. Now Moscow, what can we invest in Moscow here? Right, I think we're going to go for Winter Palace. Because look at that. Foot Guards, look at that. Simonovsky Foot Guards. Guard the Cheval. Imagine sending these down to the Don front. I think that's what we would invest in the Winter Palace. It's a big investment there from us. And we'll invest in the engineering school. So that's that. We don't need the naval board because we've got more. Oh, look at that. 6,000 Royal Academy. Wow. Now what can we invest in here in terms of, right, we've got an Army Staff College here. And we'll also get an ordnance board. That's a nice to have there. and we are going to invest, as promised, in Kiev. We can get, I hope we can get, heavy cavalry. We can indeed. And also some 24 pounders. Let's get three of those. That's a good investment right there. Oh, look at that. What a beautiful sight. They've been upgraded. What are they coming in for us? 1,400. If France come for us, I can tell you right now, my friends, we will not be holding back. We have these forces here. We will be attacking. Now, we are upgrading as quickly as we possibly can here. But we will be investing. Actually, let's invest in here a bit more. What do we need? What have we got? We've got two cannon here. I think what we will do is we'll put some more heavy cavalry into the area and also some additional... Mind you, these are nice troops as well. There's 120 of them. Actually, we'll make use of local assets. We'll put an Albanian warband in here. They're pretty good. Local assets, always useful. We did need to make some investments down in the Middle East, but we haven't had time to do that yet. All the money. What is it now? 40,841. So next turn, we will put some more money down to the Middle East here in Jerusalem. Build up this army here. What have we got? So these are all... That'll be ready, Military Academy. That'll give us many more options. Heavy cavalry would be an option as well, which is great. I'm glad I waited. We've got the great arsenal, which will give us 12 pounders. We've also got this, will give us additional bonus income. So what have we got coming here? 69,000 here. This is great. Now we know what's here. What is here? Oh my word, that's a pretty formidable force right there. Look at the hand mortars, my word. And there, that's pretty formidable forces they've got right there. But who are they at war with? Spain. But I would say they're probably struggling for money. Just like Venice is. Looks like Venice is on the verge of collapse, to be honest with you, because they are fast running out of money. Now this has been blockaded here. I can't see anything travelling, any trade going through here. They don't like us. I wonder if they'd be interested in trade. Nobody wants to know. That is never going to happen. Not ever. Why would I give them money? Not going to happen. Right, let's end the turn, my friends. We may see Venice strike out in panic because they're on the verge of collapse. They might try and strike out and take some territories from us. Oh, look. Ooh. They took a real battering there. Munich might fall because they took a beating there. Excuse me, my friends. Spain moving. That's quite a battered arm navy there. Yeah, Prussia is starting to really, really use its resources now. It's starting to outgun the French. It really is. In terms of production, finances, whoa, look at that. They've retaken Bavaria. That's what I mean, my friends. Oh my god, look at that fleet. And that's cut off Spanish trade with us. Marvellous. This is why we need to invest in our navy as well a bit more, because their naval power is pretty ferocious. Yeah, that's going to be a tough nut to crack for this French. We may have seen the beginning of the end of the French, because they've taken Bavaria quite easily there, the Prussians. It looks like they might have worn the French down. And again, they declared war on us. We would have been helping them. But nope, they decided that's what they wanted to do, and that's fine with me. But that's the consequences, my friends. Your actions have consequences, and that is what's happened. I don't understand what they're doing here. Wow. We are definitely going to be reinforcing the Prussian front there. definitely going to be reinforcing that 100%. Reinforcing that front. Ah, Wealth of Nations, my friends. Beautiful. That's going to give us machine tools. Now, can we get the machine? Yes, we can. Oh, that is fantastic. We can also, oh, we get interchangeable parts. Look at that. Minus 10 upkeep for Navy and for Army units. Wonderful. And they're getting Quicklime Shell, which is fantastic. Plus 1 to morale. Brilliant. And yes, Ukraine is going to be forming its own army here. And I want to, ooh, engineering school. I think we will put that into there. Infrastructure is good here. We're going to begin putting an army together in the Kiev here. We're not taking any chances at all. While the weather is good, we shall invest, my friends, heavily in both what we need here. It's good economy is flowing quite nicely here to France. If France did go, though, we would lose a big part of our economy. Now, what have we got down here? 1,200, we're going to invest in that. That can become a palatial estate. Army Staff College. Right, these gentlemen can join these here. As we put another army together, let's get a general. Let's invest in our army here a bit. What have we got here? We need another 24 pounder, which we can't get just yet. We'll have 3 cavalry regiments. And we shall also have some additional infantry. What have we got here? Excellent. Jerusalem and Syria have now got full commitment there. Jerusalem, we can invest in army board, and we're also going to invest in our armies down here. We do need that gunnery school here, this great arsenal, to be ready. We can't invest in any of our sort of gunnery here until we can get that, but we are going to invest in heavy cavalry here. Board here in Syria might be useful, especially against the Persians if it comes to that, and also gunnery school here. Greece has that. That's fully powered. And what about here? Military, no, actually we'd invest in another heavy first rate here. Almost got the 24 pounder ready here. And that's going to be 38,000. That's probably because Spain, yes, Spain has been cut off here, and Savoy, well, that's been cut off for a long time. But Venice has still got trade here. That must be coming overland. Yes, it is. There it is, overland. So luckily we got an overland link with Venice. Look at their troops here, they're taking a real pounding. They got more troops than they can afford to keep running. That's what it basically means. But by my, look at that, Munich has been taken. France is starting to feel the pinch here, it really is. Look at that. Calais has been hit by the Spanish. We may be seeing the sort of final, not the final, but the beginnings of the end of the French Empire here. Mind you, they do have this over here in North America here, and they've got this small redoubt here, but look at the British. The British have absolutely taken everything here. Oh, and here as well, look at that. They're in a lot of trouble, the French, a lot of trouble. So we've got to make hay while the sun is shining, because otherwise, if Prussia decides to turn against us, we could find ourselves in a lot of problems here. What about here? How are we doing here? We are investing pretty well here, actually. Can we recruit any more? Yes, we can. We'll get one more unit here in St. Petersburg. Let's keep that army there high, because look at this. The Prussians have got a lot of units in Riga. They could push against St. Petersburg pretty heavily here, and we'd be in a lot of trouble. And that's why I'm building up forces in Kiev as well. We're going to be prepared for the next war with Prussia, because it will come, believe me. We've got to invest heavily in our military, but at the same time also in our economy to support that investment, and also down here in the Middle East. What we do want to do is send this gentleman all the way back here, because remember, now we've got the roads here, it makes a difference to how the quickness and the distance which these units can travel. We need to know what's in Cairo here, just for future reference. Archangel is good now. That's being boosted pretty significantly there. These are pretty remote here, so I would probably use this army here to possibly you go on the defensive in these regions, or the offensive here using the road networks here. But it would take us a long time to be able to defend these outer regions. But Denmark seems to be just loitering about here. That is a significant investment there for Sweden. Ooh, Republican Guard. Can we help Sweden out at all, I wonder? They've got everything. They don't need our help. That's fine. Let's end the turn there, my friends. Let's see what happens here. Great Britain. France, which... feeling the brunt, my friends. It's feeling the brunt of Prussian aggression. It really is. Now they're trying to pull back here. When they're sending new forces out, maybe they're not done quite yet. But raiding. Well done, Spain. Oh my Gordon Bennett. They're being attacked by two sides now, France. Prussia sending out those fleets. Here come those armies again on the move. Are they going to strike now against Strasbourg? They are! The French Empire is starting to crumble. Jeepers creepers. We are seeing the end of France. It's as simple as that. That's why Prussia went for an alliance with us, so they could secure that flank, so they wouldn't have to fight on two fronts. So they could focus all of their might against France. Looks like it's paid off. Denmark's on the move. Thankfully, Persia is holding Venice back there, because that navy would be on its way to Greece and that otherwise. Genoa. You mind your own business, Genoa. Got a lot of trade lines being hit here. Being raided heavily. Pirates, look at that again, they're heading, wow, 38,000, so it's dropped there, we're still not getting trade. Spain is still hit here, completely cut off, but no one else, thankfully, so we still got a good income here, a steady income. Oh, look at this, now we're beginning to see the investment, the military investment starting to pay off here, the economic investment, look at that, 75,000 income. They've got nothing here at all, not a single bean. Got to bide our time here. The Ukraine is starting to gain strength here. I'm going to put a general in here. Oh, drats. What am I doing? I just disbanded that unit there. You're an idiot. What am I doing? Why am I disbanding units instead? Oh, my word. What an idiot. Right, get a grip of yourself, Malay. Get a grip of yourself. Got a three cannon here. Right. Invest in that. Got rid of those units for no need whatsoever. They're still not happy here at all, are they? Clamour for Reform 22. Modern University, we don't need the Modern University there yet. We're going to make this into a pleasure gardens. Let's increase the happiness here. That should make it a little bit happier. Classical, we don't need Classical University yet, do we? Oh, look at this. Water-powered mill. We can invest again in our economy. Keep that going. We need... got this as well coming together quite nicely. We're going to have got a general. We have to go for internal trade here. Internal trade. Royal Observatory. Then we'll go for a Royal Observatory here. $12,000, that's a big investment there for that, but still. Investment continues, my friends. $4,500 joint stock. $50 fur. Oh, commercial port. I should have been there already. Actually, I think we'll put some units in there just to be safe. Romalia. We're going to get rid of that there and then put this one into a 24-pounder. And we're going to invest in an Army Staff College in here. And an engineering school. We're going to be fully prepared for whatever comes our way. Academy here and a gunnery school. 3,423 left here to invest. A theatre. It's all come on stream quite nicely there. Thank you very much. Look at that. What a huge explosion to our investment there. Magnificent. Let's get that farm up and running. And here we're going to keep that. Gonna keep this going. What is army looking like here? Let's get the composition right. We've got. Let's get the cavalry up and running here as well. Heavy cavalry definitely prove a bonus for us here. My word, Prussia have been in a heck of a fight, but look at that, they still got this investment going. I think we have to invest a fair bit in our navy as well. I think we're going to have to really boost the income, boost the investment in our navy as well. I think that's going to be coming pretty soon. We may have a few problems here, because why are they sending these there? We're secure here. We're locked down here, and they've replenished these. 24, 12 pounders. We've got to keep the investment going in here as well. That's fine. Right, let's end the turn, my friends. Let's see what goes on here. I think France could be on the verge of collapse here, and that is no exaggeration at all. Let's end the turn and see what happens, because they're pulling back to Paris. They've still got Stuttgart. Whoa. Maybe not. Well, then they're fresh forces. They are fresh forces. Spain. Wow, Spain is strong right by there in North Africa. We've got to be careful of Morocco there, Tangier. That's going to be Prussia. What are they doing? Strasbourg. Strasbourg under threat. Sorry about that, my friends, just had a phone call there. Looks like Prussia really pushing in against France so heavily here. I think France might be collapsing. Under the sheer weight of the Prussian push here. Wow. They've even moved into the port in France itself. Hang on, Sweden has got Genoa. Oh, I see. They've pushed Genoa out. Still able to produce some ships here, but where are they going? Are they going to hit? Whoa, 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 whoa. I don't think so. I just cannot give you that, I'm afraid. I know you're desperate for regions, but that is my region. That's why I've got to build up a force in St. Petersburg. Because of that there. Because of the potential of Sweden turning against us. And why have they got those troops moving into that position there? Well done, Italian states. Denmark. Pirates. Ooh, Bosnia, another spy. Excellent. I think we'll send this gentleman over to here, into Europe proper. We're going to find out what's going on there. We've got to keep our military intelligence is absolutely vital. We have to keep an eye on what's going on at all times. I think we'll make this a theatre here. This will keep the population happy here. And, oh, that's a nice amount of investment right there. Oh, this army's coming together very nicely here. But we do need another cannon, I think, here. We can't yet. One turn for gunnery school. Army Staff College, soon going to be done. Guards will be available to us. Coming together nicely here, look at this. I think we will put another regiment of Streltsy in here. They are incredibly valuable in hand-to-hand combat. And I think the rest is going to be some more infantry. Now what was that there? 39,000, so we've increased that quite nicely, even with Spain being cut off from us. Is it still cut off from us, Spain? No, it's not. Excellent. Let's continue the growth here, or the investment here. What is the army looking like here? It needs more cavalry. And it also needs additional line infantry. Kiev, how is Kiev doing here? That's doing well here. Moscow, another army is going to be created here in Moscow. Let's get the cannon, three cannon as a standard. That has been, you know, we have decided that as a doctrine, that's going to be a standard of to have three of the heaviest caliber guns you can have in every single army. We're also going to increase our Cavalry, heavy cavalry, of course. Why are these gentlemen moving up to here? I don't like the look of this. We're not going to be losing this region, for that I can promise you. We've invested far too much into this here to go. Now at the moment our eternal... Wait a minute. Our eternal economy is looking pretty good here at the moment. I think we've got everything pretty much locked down here in terms of infrastructure and also what we've invested. So I think now... Oh, look at this. Oh, actually, that can be... Oh, look at that. Kilns. That's fantastic. I think we can start now opening up our ports. So we're going to start investing in our ports. Wait a minute. Wait just a minute. Yeah, we'll get pleasure gardens as well. We're going to start investing in our ports and also in our navy here. Got a compliment here. We're going to actually get another general. And line infantry. We're going to invest. Here we're going to have another heavy first rate here and another one here. And then we're going to invest in one of these ports here. I think probably the safest ports to have are going to be these here in the Black Sea. 400. What about these down by here? 525. Right, Greece is going to be where we're going to put out a major investment here. We're going to start investing now in these ports here. Ooh, 700. I beg your pardon, my friends. That's coming out. We're going to have this here in Bosnia. Put this one here, 700 as well. So that'll be our next one. Got, what have we got coming in here? 39,000. This will be our last turn now, my friends, but we... Look at this. France is absolutely buckling under the pressure. They're right on the verge of Paris, and I'm not joking. This army here could probably take Paris if it wanted to. Only because Savoy is here helping them that they may be able to hold it, but France is in a lot of trouble. A huge amount. We might see the end of France here. Turn. Great Britain. They've got a huge fleet. My word, look at the fleet here. Wow, look at all these Mughal here. What are they doing there? Come on now, France. I think they're withdrawing. They're pulling back from the front lines. Spain is moving up probably a lot of troops there, but France is in a lot of trouble, a lot of trouble. The Prussian onslaught has been unrelenting, it really has been absolutely brutal. Oof, they got thrown back there. They've just held on there, just in Stuttgart, by the skin of their teeth. Prussia's war with Spain continues. Ooh, they skirted Paris. Persia. Mughal, Italian states, Denmark. Denmark's still on the move here, Venice. But I think Venice is starting to again feel the effects here of not much income. They've got a bigger army than their actual economy. Their economy can't sustain their armies. Wow, France is just absolutely being battered to pieces here. Pirates. Who seem to be still loitering about these trade lines. Yeah, 35,000 now. What? Ah, France been hit. That's why. That's why we've got to invest while we can here. Oh, look, that is very nice. That's looking very nice indeed here. Moscow, that's getting this army up and running quite nicely here. We are going to be calling for a general. A lot of these are just keeping this area in check here. We need a modern university for this. So, we've got to invest in the modern university there to be able to get the rest of our income there. 4,500 there for those pelts. It's a big investment, but we might have to do it. I think Moscow's going to require more troops. Oh, Vladislav Buzhov is gone. I must have died in here in the... Another gentleman has died. Gunnery school for the 12-pounder. Actually, yeah, we do need that because we want to get 24-pounders eventually. How are these two gentlemen doing here? We've got the general. We do need now, we can now invest in 24 12-pounders, three of those, as is the standard doctrine here for our armies. What do we got here? 5,000. We were going to invest in Serbia, I believe it is. No, Bosnia, beg your pardon. And yes, it was Croatia. It's 400. Where was that other trade? There it is there. Austria. 5,000 in there to keep this highest. But look at that, they're almost overlapping here. So our army upkeep is going to soon exceed our income. Quicklime shells are ready. Oh no, our general has died there. Drats. Let me get a new general. Won't be the same. But still, ordnance board, as we get this gentleman here. We're going to invest in the governor's palace to increase our bonus for the tax income. And also say to everybody else, we are going to be staying here. That's looking good there, that's excellent. We get a palatial estate there, right on the border here. But France is barely holding on to Stuttgart here. Oh my god, they're being absolutely hit all around here. Yeah, that's where it is. Look at that. The Spanish forces here moving in. Catalonia Regiment. Let's get one more regiment there. 700 for that one. 5,000. That's going to take the rest of our money. We've got to invest in our economy here. This has been an excellent, excellent, really an excellent couple of years for us, my friends. It really has. We've been really able to invest pretty heavily here. We've still got this a good army here, which would be able to defend pretty much anything coming its way here. It really would. That one would be able to stop pretty much any Persian force coming across that bridge. And we are investing quite heavily now in our armies here, getting this army up and running here, and also in Kiev, which has almost got a full stack army, which is fantastic to see. Can defend itself now against the Prussians. Should they and also here in St. Petersburg, recruitment here has stopped, but can we get any other? No, no more line infantry here. We could get a 24-pounder, but I think we will do actually. We'll make this army here have 4 batteries here of artillery. That'll make it really formidable. But my friends, I'm going to end this episode here. I hope you've enjoyed it. It's been one where we've been watching events on other fronts. We've also been investing in our army and in our infrastructure and our economy whilst we can, whilst everything is going well for us here. We really are pushing this heavily in our favour, hopefully, so we can fight back against any aggressors that come our way. Hope you've enjoyed this, my friends. If you have, please comment, like, and subscribe. Please keep your comments coming down below. As always, they really, really do help. They've been absolutely fantastic. Hope you're having a good week thus far, my friends. And whatever you're doing for the rest of the week, please be safe. And I hope everything goes well for you. But until next time, my friends, I can promise you possibly more action coming our way. We might strike it out against the Ottomans, depending on how the political winds are blowing. But until next time, my friends, bye for now.